Good morning, Cedar Park. Today is Thursday, February 9th, 2023, and it's an A-Day.
On today's Wolfcast, take a look at one of our spectacular seniors, wrestler Erica Peterson. And let's recap some of the best moments from yesterday's Black History Month Q&A panel.
Today's headlines on this morning's brief, a new T-Wolf spotlight with Carver, and a Throwback Thursday segment from the Wolfcast archives.
Turn up because the Wolfcast starts now. Good morning, Cedar Park, and welcome back. I'm Reagan Hill, and I'm here this morning with Reed Cummins and Katie Whitmarsh.
Wrestling season is now in full swing, and a big force on our girls' team is senior Erica Peterson.
With her sharp reflexes and her position of a Texas state placer, Erica is followed by tremendous support as her journey progresses. Here's Tanvi with more.
After hearing about this incredible news, we took a certain dive into the highlights of Erica's life, and here's what we found.
Senior Erica Peterson has been wrestling since the very start of her high school career. Following in her family's footsteps, Erica says she hopes to achieve her goals. Her dream is to satisfy not only her family, but herself included. Erica emphasizes on these further points.
Wrestling's huge in my family. My dad wrestled, and then he coached college teams, high school teams, you name it. My brothers both wrestled in high school. So I kind of got to watch them go through it, and I wanted to do it myself. Right around the time when I wanted to start wrestling, women's wrestling started like really getting big. And so it was like perfect timing. I was like, cool, I want to be one of those girls. So I did it.
Unfortunately for Erica, one of her biggest matches would turn out to be her downfall. After a brutal match against a competitive rival from Glenn, Erica sadly suffered one of her most agonizing injuries. This injury has had a great impact on her for a while, mentally and physically.
So it was last year, and at Thanksgiving time, she had dislocated her elbow, and it was a pretty brutal dislocation. I was with her mat side when she dislocated it, and the injury did not go back into place. So they actually put her on an ambulance, and her elbow was still out until she got to the hospital. So I actually thought her season was done, something of that nature. I was like, there's no way, and there's torn ligaments and probably something broken in there. But she pretty much willed her way back onto the mat.
Still recovering from this traumatic loss, Erica headed to state finals, determined to bring home the trophy no matter what.
When we got to the state tournament, first I was just excited for her to be there. But when the match that she ended up winning to be on the placing round, we actually have a funny story about it. So when she wins in that level, I usually am pretty excited in the corner, cheering, going pretty crazy. And she looked over in the corner, and it was really quiet. And so she actually thought she had lost. But then as she got closer to me, she saw that I was actually starting to cry because it was really emotional for me.
The relationship between Erica and her father is considered to be closer than ever. With their constant time spent together, the two of them have become to be closer than ever before. Together, the experiences they share have come to touch many hearts, and their future holds a great story.
Yeah, so my dad and I are close, super close actually. You know, we don't have like a normal parent-daughter relationship. He's like my best friend, so.
Erica has definitely found her future pathway and continues to strive with great success. After winning against one of her rivals from Glenn High School, Erica came face-to-face with success, awaiting her arrival. With all smiles and cheers, Erica knows just how to overcome any new challenge that she sees, and we know just how well her future will turn out to be.
Anyway, it's been a fun ride, so I'm going to be sad. I'm going to be really, really sad when it's done, but I am looking forward to the next level for her of going and competing and her resetting her goals to a much higher level goal.
Following Erica's wonderful example, joining wrestling will also help you thrive. Considering this can help you find a new talent as well as compete at many different levels.
As Black History Month began a little over a week ago, CPHS held a panel where various speakers could answer questions about their various experiences and identity. Yesterday during DEN, the CPHS Black History Month Q&A panel was hosted by both the CPHS Equity Team and CPHS News. The panel consisted of four Black community members, including staff from LASD, where they discussed and answered an array of questions pertaining to experiences, perspectives, and more with being Black.
I was so focused on the stereotypical images of what I needed to be that I stopped focusing on what I wanted to be. And once I got a true understanding of the history of African Americans, I realized one thing. Whatever I wanted to do in life, other people who look like me have already, I'm following in their pathway. And that liberated me to pursue my goal.
Attending panels like this are a great way to get involved in your local community.
The diversity clubs at CPHS never cease to amaze, and this time around, the Garage Band Club has got our attention. Led by Trevor Von Wupperpeel, the Garage Band Club is a place for musically talented people to come together without a stress of an intense agenda. The Garage Band Club is a place where students go to play their instruments without having any particular requirement. A few times a week, the club meets and plays together after school. Club President Trevor Von Wupperpeel shares what the Garage Band Club is and all about during their first ever meeting.
So the Garage Band Club is about it's for musicians in our school, as we feel like the school doesn't really have a whole lot of music infrastructure other than like the band and the choir. So we're kind of providing a place for musicians to get together and kind of play their instruments without a huge obligation towards them. But it's also for more freeform instruments, like we bring our electric guitars and basses, and we're going to bring a drum set in pretty soon here.
To attend the Garage Band Club, simply head to the library after school on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, or Fridays, and make sure to bring your instruments as they aren't provided.
Coming up, the brief with Ryan Green, but first, this break. Welcome back. I'm Ryan Green, and these are today's headlines on The Brief. First up, another update on the spy balloon from China. The spy balloon that we all know by now is tied to a major surveillance program run by China's military, according to intel sources. This is not the first time these surveillance balloons have been seen from China. 4 months ago, there was another balloon discovered after it crashed into the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii. There were another three that were found to have flown over Texas, Florida, and Guam over the past few years. It is unclear how long this surveillance program has been going on. Next, the earthquake in Turkey and Syria hits a death toll around 17,000. Residents there have criticized the government's efforts for aid, saying rescuers were slow to arrive. Rescue teams in Turkey and Syria continue to search for signs of life in the rubble. Teams from more than two dozen countries have joined tens of thousands of local emergency personnel in the effort. Finally, an 18-year-old in Canada has won the lottery on her first try, winning $48 million Canadian dollars. Her first instinct was to call her dad for financial advice. She plans to finish her university degree and become a doctor. She will also invest some of that money while using some of that money to travel the world with her family. So what would you guys do if you won the lottery? If I won the lottery in Canada, I would probably make different decisions than if I won it here. Because if I won it here, I'd probably like buy like a boat or something. But if I won it in Canada, I'd have to like buy something cold.
What does that have to like
what
factor into what you buy?
I don't know. You don't buy warm things in Canada because it's cold there.
They have a summer.
Yeah, but
they have a nice summer actually.
And there's boats there too.
Yeah, what about, they have water.
Yeah, boats in Canada.
I mean, yeah.
What would you buy, Katie?
College.
Right.
College, a house, a car, like, really just college. Imagine going to college for 100% free. Oh, what a life.
That'd in be Canada, so nice. Though.
Or I could get a boat like Reed, that's fine.
Awesome.
Okay, well, thanks, Ryan. Now let's throw it over to Carver McDonald for your T-Wolf Spotlight.
Yeah, so for high school, I'm kind of starting out here with baseball head coach and Forrest and Junior K. Davis. Let's talk baseball. Coach, as your Parker alumni, what was it like to play baseball at Sierra Park High School back in the day?
It was a special experience getting to be part of this program. Lots of great history, lots of great people have come through here. But getting to play here, it's very unique. Getting to create that brotherhood with a lot of the guys, you know, you develop lifelong relationships with people, and still to this day, I talk with a lot of those guys that I still played baseball with, and even guys that I've had the opportunity to coach, some including like your brother, or I guess both your brothers. It's just a very special place.
Yes, it is. Kate, you are... Can you start over?
That was funny. You're good, buddy.
Back at number one.
Should be the
on the second. On the second one?
Mm-hmm.
Number two?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Kate, you are on a 50 players to watch list this season. Does that give you any additional pressure?
I wouldn't say it adds any pressure. Even with all the work that we put in, and to get better at the game, at the end of the day, it's still a game. And so we just want to go out there and have fun and just be yourself.
Yeah. What are you most excited about this season?
I'm excited to win some ball games, I'll tell you that. I want to make a run in playoffs. That's what I've wanted most. Go state championship.
Okay. When can we catch the boys playing at home?
Our very first tournament is a tournament that we're hosting at home from the 23rd, 24th, and 25th. All those games will be at home.
Okay. Well, that's all the questions I have for you today. Thank you, Kate and Forrest. Recipes News, back to you guys.
Thanks, Carver.
Now, before we go, here's a special Throwback Thursday segment from our Wolfcast archives in 2009. All for today on tomorrow's show, a feature on Cedar Park IT specialist, Mr. Bickling.
Figure out some weekend plans with weekend destinations.
Plus a Friday sports report.
Thanks for taking time to join us during your den. You can catch anything you missed and more on our Twitter or YouTube at CPHS News.
You can also follow at @CPHS_sports for updates during the games. With CPHS News, I'm Katie Whitmarsh.
I'm Reed Cummins.
And I'm Reagan Hill. Remember to make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.